Hi, I'm Mike Redding from the Google Apps for Education community and the blog over at googleappsforedu.com. In today's short video, I'm going to show you how we can use a script inside Google Docs to easily create mail merge documents. Okay, so you'll notice here in my Google Drive folder that I've already created a few documents, and I'm going to assume that you know how to create these. If you don't, then I'll put some links to some videos that will show you the process beneath this video. So I've just created a simple spreadsheet that has first name, last name, and their elective choice next to it. And I've created a mail merge doc that just uses the double brackets here as the mail merge field identifier. So you can see that there's a mail merge field here, and there's another mail merge field just here. Now, to make this work, what we need to do is we need to go back to our spreadsheet and we need to install a script. So we're going to go down here to Insert and then Script. And the script name that we're looking for is called Autocrat. So let's just type that in there and we'll see it just here. So we're going to click Install. Now, just like every other time when you install a script for the first time, that script will just ask for your permission to be able to access your documents. So you need to just give the authorization for that. And as soon as we've clicked on accept, what will happen is that the script will now sit on our toolbar just up the top here. So here's how we run our document. Firstly, we click on the Autocrat script and we click Run Initial Configuration. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to choose where we're getting our template. What's our merge document? Now, if I click on Choose Template, you'll notice that this is the document mail merge demo. It's the same document as the one I just showed you that I had already created. So I'm just going to select that one and then that will file it for us. Now we just click Save Settings, and then what will happen is the script will then go and find the source data. Now at the moment, I've only got one sheet inside my document down the bottom here, so I only have one option to choose from. And this is where we now start to merge our document. Don't worry too much about this information just here, just click Submit. Now it's gone back and found my merge document and knows that it needs to find information for the first name and information from the elective. Now these words don't have to relate back to anything inside your spreadsheet, because what I can do is just choose the column that I would like. So first name, I'm obviously going to choose first name, and elective, I'm going to choose the elective choice. So now it knows where to pull that information from. So we just click there, Save Settings. And now what will happen is that script will start to build. So the first thing we need to do now is just say where we want our document to be saved. Don't freak out too much about all this information up here. We just need to click this box here and say where we would like to save it. Now, if I jump back over to my Drive folder for a second, you'll see that I've created a folder inside my mail merge doc folder that is where my documents will be saved. So I'm simply going to come over here, choose that mail merge docs folder just there, and then we need to say how we'd like to name our document. Obviously, when you create a document, it creates one copy for every person who is going to receive a response. And so you might like to name that document, so it might be Mike's elective choice, for instance. So to do that, we come up here to our list of options and we click on first name and just highlight that and drop it in here. And so first name, and I can go elective choice. Now, if you had more than one person with the name Mike, you might go first name and then go up and grab last name. So it'd be first name, last name, elective choice. The next thing that we get to decide is what format we want that document to be created in. Do we want to keep it in a Google Doc, or do we want to create a PDF? Now, once you've decided what type of doc that you would like, then what you can do is email or share that document with the person that you're merging the document for. Now, you could put the recipient email address in here. I don't have that option because in my spreadsheet over here, I didn't ask for their email address. But if you had, that would come up here as an option for you, and this would automatically find those email addresses and send each person a copy. Now, the great thing about this is if you come down here to attachment type, you can then determine, is this doc that you're going to share with them something that can just be viewed or whether or not they can edit? So you're able to individually share documents with others and then automatically determine what their rights are going to be in terms of that doc. The last thing that we have here is a box where we can trigger merge on form submit. If your spreadsheet was linked back to a Google form, then what can happen is that Autocrat can run automatically in the background, and every time somebody fills out the form, it will automatically process that form, merge the document, email the document to them. So it's not something that you have to do manually, which is a fantastic time saver. So at the moment, I'm just going to untick that, and then I'm going to click Save Settings. And now what we can do is we can say, do we want to just test it on the first row? So you might have put your data in there to start off with to test it. You can run the whole thing, or you could have just set it up and say, don't run just yet. I'm just going to run the merge. Now, if I go back to my Drive folder and click on Merge Docs, you'll see that I have the three documents that I've created. They've all been automatically named for me. And if I open up one of the documents, you'll see that the fields are open for me just here. So it says, hi Pete, there was a first name. This is a quick reminder that your Minecraft elective starts at 3:30. If we go back to our sheet, you'll see that Peter has a Minecraft elective, and there it is there. So hopefully you can see how you'd be able to use this to save yourself a lot of time when merging documents. The automatic trigger feature is fantastic. There is some features for you to create a document link inside here as well, so that you can just link to those documents really quickly. If you have any questions, love you to drop a question or a comment in the comment section below, and we can continue the discussion from there. If you'd like to receive any other tips or tricks, we'd encourage you head over to googleappsforedu.com. There you'll find a wealth of information about how you can use Google Apps for education. Thanks for watching.